AI trip planning could be the smartest way for you to plan your next holiday, but can you really trust AI getting the best result for you? In this video, you'll see how to use ChatGPT to plan your perfect trip for free with no apps, no subscription, and no tech skills required. My name is Michael. I'm a New Zealand travel designer with decades of trip planning experience. In three simple steps, I'll show you how to combine AI with real-world travel know-how to create a truly memorable New Zealand holiday. So let's get started. So this is what we're going to do. We will review two itineraries, one created through AI with ChatGPT against a handcrafted professional sample travel plan by a local expert, myself. For this test, we'll use a 14-day North and South Island New Zealand itinerary. We then review the results and point out things going right and where AI still falls short. Then we'll review on how you can use AI to plan a trip that actually works in the real world with the amazing efficiencies AI offers. This will be a game changer on how you plan travel into the future, so stay around this video as each step is important. So this is what we're going to do. We log into ChatGPT. You can create an account. It's completely free of charge. Then we add a text prompt to get a result from ChatGPT. So here's the prompt. Please provide a New Zealand travel itinerary for the North and South Island for 14 days, couple. The first time to New Zealand, we want to do a self-drive holiday. It's about interests. We want to see as much as possible, but we don't want the experience, stress, etc., etc. Travel dates, locations into New Zealand, 1st of November. You can download this prompt in the description box below. Now let's have a look what ChatGPT comes up with for your first result. But here's where things getting interesting, because this AI generated trip might look good on paper, but in the real world, not so much. Now we have our first result from ChatGPT, and I want to go through day by day to give you my feedback on that. So we have day 1 and 2, Auckland and Waiheke Island. That is fine. Then day 3, 4, Rotorua. That is fine too, though the driving time, sometimes you need to be careful. That could be a little bit longer, 10-15% normally you have to add with Google Maps. Then you have 1 night, day 5 in Taupo. Most likely you could spend 2 nights there and do a day trip into the Tongariro National Park. So that's fine. But then you have a drive right down to Wellington. Again, the driving time could easily be longer than 4.5 hours. Then take the ferry to Picton. Again, you know, you have to check in, 3.5 hours on the ferry. You need to keep in mind that sometimes the ferries are canceled or delayed. So then you have here 1 night in Kaikoura, 1 night in Christchurch. I generally recommend to have as much as possible 2 nights at each location to have a much more balanced itinerary, really. Then you travel down to Lake Tekapo and you obviously stay 2 nights. You have the day you arrive, and then the next day you do a day trip into Mount Cook National Park. It doesn't make much sense really to change again the accommodation. It would rather stay 2 nights. And then you go down to Queenstown, and 1 night is a bit light because that Queenstown area is very popular. There's lots to do, and also you totally miss the Fiordland National Park. So here are some other suggestions on accommodation, tour recommendations, and trips. So that's what we have so far. Now let's refine this itinerary template we received with a little bit more detail and a little bit more local knowledge. Still with me? Now we've done the basics, soon we'll dive into ways on how to combine the best of the two worlds. So what we're now doing is we're adding some more prompts. Again, you can download these prompts in the description box below. So we're using a sample itinerary with locations, services, rental car, etc. We're using existing web links. We want to use recommended stops on the itinerary. We want to have daily timing. We want to have Google Map links and text description in between each location. So what we're now doing, this is crucial again, you can download this in the box below, is we will add now a PDF file, which provides us with that kind of local knowledge we want for this tailor-made itinerary for yourself. If you find this video helpful, you may want to hit the subscribe button below to stay in touch for more helpful travel videos to come. Now it's coming back with a question. Let me know if you want that preference as above. And yes, we want, and let's start with day one. Start with day one. So what you see now, it's started to implement that information from the PDF. So we have hotel links, we have a bit of description, we have suggestions on what you can do. There are tour links, there are ferry links and dinner suggestions and also timing, so which is really handy. What we're going to do now, we instruct ChatGPT to provide us with a full 14-day itinerary. You basically just want to give those prompts as you would talk to somebody. It's not like in Google, but you provide ChatGPT with the next steps, what it should do. So let's see what it comes up with. Now we have actually the complete day 1 to 14, either as a spreadsheet here or as a text document. It shows actually what it's done. So we have the daily route and destinations. We have the accommodation listed by stars. We have top tours and activities with links. We have the Google Maps and each for each day. And we have scenic highlights and spots along the way. We can now ask ChatGPT to provide the itinerary as a Word document. Let's do that first. Now we have here the Word document downloaded. Let's have a quick look into it. So we have here an outline with the days, we've got the locations, we've got the accommodation options, we got the links for the tours. So it's all very nicely laid out and you can use this as it is. Again, the key advantage here, and I'll go through the itinerary quickly, is that you're combining AI with local knowledge. So what we have here is we have Auckland. You have one night in Auckland only. You stay whatever accommodation you want to stay, and then you head down from Auckland to Waitomo and to Rotorua, which actually saves you quite a bit of time in respect of visiting locations. You can do that like the Hamilton Gardens, you can do Ruakuri, Blackwater, etc., etc. So you can also check all the itinerary on the PDF provided, which is basically the same itinerary. Two nights location in Rotorua. Depends if you want to go Tongariro, then you would stay in Taupo, but then you actually fly down to Queenstown and drive directly to Te Anau. So you're not having these many one-night stays. You want to stay as much as possible for two nights, as mentioned before. Then a day trip to Fiordland, then you head into Milford Sound basically. Then from Te Anau you go back to Queenstown. Then you can start exploring and you have a couple of nights in Queenstown. Again, here are the links for what you can do. That means you have a little bit more time. It's less driving, especially with the domestic flights we have included. Then we heading up the west coast to Franz Josef. Then we head over to Punakaiki and we head over to the Nelson Tasman region. From the Nelson Tasman region, we can then either fly back to Auckland if you want to spend a little bit more time in the South Island and the southern parts, or you can go, like with this itinerary, you can go to Kaikoura through Plenum, and that makes perfectly sense. In respect of having two nights there again, you can do whale watch, etc. And then you drive down to Christchurch. So if you look at the map, this makes actually perfect sense. And from Christchurch, you can either take your international flight out of New Zealand, or you can fly back to Auckland and connect with your international flight. So this is a really cool way of combining that local knowledge we provide with the sample itineraries and using ChatGPT. So by using the prompts we put in there, you can actually design your itinerary in a matter of minutes, really. So, and you can have the confidence that this itinerary will actually work. Now, if you prefer to have this itinerary as a table outline, then we can also provide that command to ChatGPT, and let's have a look what it's doing. So here we see that we can now download an Excel file. So let's do that. So here's our Excel file. We can obviously increase the size a little bit to make it a bit more visible. Let's put the font up a bit more, and then we basically can do a little bit of work here. But at the end of the day, you will get all the details we have on ChatGPT based on the itinerary provided, the sample itinerary provided, with links and all the details you need to know. Now that's a trip I'll put my name onto. And yes, AI was helpful, but the magic is to combine what practically already works in travel with AI. So here's what I recommend. Use AI for the basics like route outlines or brainstorming activities. Work with a real-world travel itinerary template to refine your plan. Check everything, drive times, seasonal access, availability. Also use local knowledge, things like staying 2 to 3 nights at key locations to avoid travel stress. Now, after you have a solid plan, you also want to check when is the best time to travel to New Zealand and learn about the season. So check out this video up here to get your trip perfect. Thanks very much for watching. See you in the next video.